for your math class 8th, and today we all are going to start chapter 1st, that is rational numbers. Before starting rational number, you should know about the few numbers which already you have discussed in earlier classes. First is natural numbers. The counting numbers are called natural numbers. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. And the next category is whole numbers. Whole numbers, the collection of all the natural numbers, including 0, are called whole numbers. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to so on. In that, these all numbers are natural numbers. And if we add one more number, that is 0, that becomes a whole number. And the symbol used for whole number, that is W. With W, we can denote whole numbers. And the next category, that is negative numbers. Negative numbers, all the natural numbers with negative sign are called negative numbers. For example, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, up to so on. Similarly, next category is positive numbers. All the natural numbers are also known as positive numbers. Means positive number and natural number both are similar. Example, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. And after this comes integers. Integers are the collection of all the natural numbers, negative numbers, and zero are called integers. Or in simple language, what you can say, the integers are collection of whole numbers, and negative numbers. Negative numbers is called integers. And one more thing I want to tell you, that is, zero is neither positive nor negative. It is neutral because it is not having any sign. Rational numbers. The numbers which can be written as in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equals to zero, are called rational numbers. All the whole numbers, natural numbers, fractions, integers are rational numbers. As I'll make you understand with this example, like 2 by 3 is a rational number, but 2 by 3 is fraction as well. So only difference between the rational numbers and fraction is that the fractions are always positive and the rational numbers can be negative. As another example, we can take 4. 4 is rational number because 4 can be written as in the form of P upon Q as 4 by 1, where P is equals to 4 and Q is equals to 1. Similarly, 0 is also a rational number because it can also be written as in the form of P upon Q, where P is equals to 0 and Q is equals to 1. But 1 over 0 is not a rational number because here Q is equals to 0. Q is not equals to 0 is the necessary condition. So 0, 1 by 0 is not a rational number. And if we just go further, then the standard form of a rational number. What is the standard form? So standard or simplest form of a rational number is the number should be in the form of P upon Q, and where Q not equals to 0. One thing more in that, the HCF of P and Q should be 1. Common factor between P and Q should be 1. Then the particular number will be in the simplest form. For example, 2 by 3 is in the standard form or in the simplest form. How it will be? Because 2 and 3 both are having common factor only 1. So HCF of both numbers is 1. So 2 by 3 is in the standard form. Similarly, 4 by 6 is not a standard form, because 4 by 6 can be cancelled out further, and the HCF of 4 and 6 is not 1. So next is absolute value of rational number. The absolute value is the numerical value without its sign. Sign means neither positive nor negative. And the absolute value can be denoted by the sign modulus. Modulus means that symbol mod is used for absolute value. For example, if we have to find out absolute value of minus 4 by 5, then keep this value in modulus, then you will get output 4 by 5. Either this number is of plus or minus, but output you will get, that will be always positive. Similarly, next, as if both the numbers you are taking negative, minus 3 over minus 7 modulus, then what you will get? 3 by 7, that will be positive number. Always you will get positive number. And the students, you have to solve a recap exercise. Recap exercise question number 1, I am not going to solve complete exercise, but only one part I'll sort out, and the rest part you have to sort out. So first is addition. Add the following: 4 by 9 and 1 by 3. So first of all, we have to see the denominators. If denominators both are different, then take the LCM of both denominators. As here in this example, number 9 and 3. Take the LCM of number 3 and 9. By this method, ladder method, you can apply 3 into 3 and 9. So firstly, you have to take prime number 2. Because 3 and 9 is not divisible by 2, so the next prime number is 3. Divide it 3 with 1, it goes on 1. Same as 3, multiply 3, it will be 9, so it goes on 3. Then again it will go on 3, answer will be 1 and then 1. So LCM is equals to 9. As you have taken LCM 9, so how you have to add 9? Divide with 9, denominator, divide it with the denominator. 9 divide with 9, you will get 1. So 1 multiply with 4. So 4 by 9. And same as 9, so in that 9 divide with 3, you will get answer 3, and 3 multiply with 1. So you will get answer 3. 4 plus 3 is equals to 7, and downside is 9, so denominator is 9. Students, or you can apply another method, that is, you can make the denominator of both the fractions equal by multiplying it with that number which makes the denominator equal. For example, 4 by 9, there is need not to multiply it with any number, so it can be multiplied with 1 only, 4 by 9. Similarly, 1 by 3, there is need to multiply so that we can get 9. So 1 by 3 will be multiplied with 3 by 3, so you will get 3 by 9. Now add these both the fractions or rational numbers, then you will get answer 7 by 9. So similarly, as next question is subtract. In that you have to subtract the rational numbers. If we subtract two rational numbers, then answer which we will get, that will be also a rational number. So here is example, minus 3 by 8 minus 5 by 8. So take the LCM of downside numbers. There is need not to take LCM because both the numbers are same. Then directly we can take as 8 is a LCM of these both numbers. So 8 is LCM. 8 divided with 8, you will get answer 1. 1 is multiplied with numerator, then you will get minus 3. Same as 8 is divisible by 8, you will get 1. 1 is multiplied with numerator, then it will be minus 5. Now both the numbers are of minus, minus 3, minus 5, then you will get minus 8 and denominator is 8. Now you got answer minus 8 over 8. After cancelling you will get answer minus 1. So now multiply two rational numbers. Rational numbers are given in the mixed fractions. So firstly we have to make it in the improper fractions. 3 multiply with 3, 1, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. So answer is 5 by 3. And the next improper fraction will change 5 into 4, 20. 20 plus 1, 21 over 5. And 5 and 5 can be cancelled out. 5 ones are 5 and 5 ones are 5. So now you are left with answer 21 over 3. But my dears, that also can be cancelled out. 3 ones are 3 and 3 sevens are 21. So you are left with answer 7 by 1. This is your final answer. Similarly, let's discuss about one more question that is related to divide. Divide 5 into 1 by 3. Divide 8 by 9. So this is again mixed fraction and this is a rational number. So firstly change it into improper fraction. 5 into 3, 15 plus 1, 16 upon 3, division 8 by 9. So my dears, there is one concept. When you are going to divide two numbers and both are in the fractional form, then how you have to sort out, look here, 16 by 3, this division sign will be changed into multiplication and this number will be reciprocal. So reciprocal of 8 by 9. If you go for reciprocal, then the complete number will come 1 over 8 over 9. So this becomes 9 by 8. Just reciprocal the number 8 over 9, this will be changed into 9 by 8. So now this can be cancelled out. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. Same as 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. So you got answer 2 multiply 3, that is 6. Next question is, write the absolute value as question 1 is minus 18 over 25 modulus and we have to find out absolute value. And in absolute value, what you have to do? You have to write the numerical value without its sign. Means need not to go for this minus. So you will get answer only 18 over 25. Similarly, another question. 4 by 5 plus minus 6 by 5 modulus. So firstly, there is need to sort out the term which are given inside with operation plus. So it will be LCM of 5 and 5. It will be 5. 5 divide with 5, then you will get 1. 1 multiply with 4, you will get 4. Similarly, next number, 5 divide with 5 and then multiply with minus 6. So 5 divide with 5, 1. 1 is multiply with minus 6. You got minus 6. So now 4 minus 6. Then answer is minus 2 by 5. Modulus is there. Then you will get answer without sign. So it will be 2 by 5. So next is verify. Modulus A multiply B is equals to modulus A multiply modulus of B. The values for A is minus 4 by 7 and for B 7 by 8. So let's try. Firstly, we'll sort out with left side. Modulus of A multiply modulus of B. So insert the value of A in modulus. Minus 4 by 7 modulus multiply 7 by 8 modulus. So 4 by 7, because this is already we have done absolute value. What will be the answer of this? Without sign. Minus sign will not be there. So answer will be 4 by 7 only. Multiplication same as 7 by 8 modulus. So answer will be 7 by 8. 7 can be cancelled out with 7. So then you will get answer 4 by 8, but 4 by 8 also further can be cancelled out. 4 ones are 4 and 4 twos are 8. So answer is 1 by 2. So let's see right hand side whether this is equal or not, because we have to verify that both the sides are equal. So let's check left side. Modulus of A multiply B modulus. So insert value same way. Modulus minus 4 by 7 multiply 7 by 8 modulus. So after cancelling 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8 and 7 ones are 7 and 7 ones are 7. So modulus same as minus 1 by 2 mod. Now if this is absolute value, then what will be output? Output will be without sign. It will be 1 by 2 only. Now students, look here. Left side 1 by 2 and the right side also 1 by 2. So our question is solved. Left side is equals to right hand side equals to 1 by 2. So hence our question is verified. So that is the last question of exercise. Last is, the sum of two rational number is 2 by 9 and one number is given 1 by 3. Find the other number. So how you have to go for this? The other number will be equals to sum minus one number. You can subtract that particular number which is given from the sum. So sum is 2 by 9 minus 1 by 3. So 9 and 3 both denominators are different. There is need to take a LCM. So LCM will be 9. So LCM 9, 9 divided with 9, you will get 1. 1 is multiplied with 2, you will get 2. Then sine of minus 9 divided with 3, you will get 3. 3 multiplied with 1, you will get 3. So after subtracting 2 minus 3, you are left with minus 1 and denominator 9. So final answer is minus 1 by 9. So other number is equals to 1 by 9. Okay students, now rest of the parts you have to sort out. Okay, thank you.